अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज जर्मिनेशन. इन जर्मिनेशन फर्स्ट द सीड इज बरड इन द सॉयल. द सीड एम्बाइब्स और टेक इन वाटर एंड द आउटर मोस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सीड बर्स्ट. इट मीन्स द सीड कोट ब्रेक डाउन एंड द रूट कम्स आउट. द रूट ग्रोज एंड एब्जॉर्ब मोर वाटर. आफ्टर द रूट द शूट कम्स आउट एंड मूव अबव द सॉयल. This shoot further grows into leaves and flowers. Now we are going to read this topic. When any seed falls onto the ground or is planted or maybe it is buried in the soil, it needs the right conditions in order to grow. Right condition means proper amount of water, sunlight and in the presence of oxygen. The soil should be rich and fertile. It means important nutrients that are required to the seed are present in the soil. There should be plenty of fresh air because fresh air has oxygen and enough sunlight and warmth. And warmth is provided by the sunlight. And of course, water. If the conditions are right, the seed will germinate. The seed absorbs water. The water makes the food inside the seed quite soft. Basically, this food is present in the cotyledon. Cotyledon has the nutritive tissues that provide food to the baby plant. It also helps to break open the seed coat. Inside the seed, the baby plant begins to grow. Here are the stages of germination in a bean plant. The seed is buried in the soil. It gets warmth and water. The seed coat becomes soft. The seed leaves become soft and open. Seed leaves means cotyledon. The root begins to grow downwards and absorb water. The shoot grows upward, reaching for air and the warmth of sunlight. Leaves appear on the shoot. These will enable the plant to produce and store food for energy. Because leaves have chlorophyll, green pigment, in the presence of sunlight and carbon dioxide, these leaves make their food. The stem grows stronger and more leaves appear. Eventually, buds appear and these blossom into flowers which produce seed. This is a bud, which further blossom into flowers. Here is a question, and the statement of the question is that make a list of the conditions most seeds need in order to germinate. And the answer is that the soil should be rich and fertile. It means important nutrients which are required for the growth of a plant or seed are present in the soil. There should be plenty of fresh air and enough sunlight and warmth, and of course water. These are the conditions which are required to a seed to grow into a plant. Hope you will understand this chapter, because I had given brief knowledge and explain in detail about plants, classification of plants, means flowering plants and non-flowering plants, compared the monocot and dicot plants. Thank you for listening.